So, we have to start with the tertiary wind pattern or local wind. And we have seen like primary wind patterns or planetary wind pattern or permanent wind patterns are like northeast trade wind, southeast trade wind, and we have seen westerlies, we have seen polar easterlies, and secondary wind patterns are in the form of tropical cyclone, temperate cyclone, subtropical jet stream, polar front jet stream, monsoons. These are what is the wind which is originated, wind pattern which is originated due to the primary wind pattern. It is known as secondary wind pattern, and tertiary wind pattern which is come into existence due to the local changes in, I said, local changes in atmospheric attributes. Somewhere pressure changes, temperature changes. So local changes in atmospheric attributes and physiographic effect. I said that local changes in atmospheric attributes and physiographic effect led to the what development of local wind or tertiary wind. Write down the definition of tertiary wind or local wind. I said it is a such wind which came into existence due to dynamic change in atmospheric attributes, due to dynamic change in atmospheric attributes and change in local physiography and change in local physiography or slope pattern. Slope pattern. So if I say that the first land bridge and sea bridge, if I am talking about, we have to understand one topic, like I said, that specific heat. One concept you should be aware of, I said that, what is specific heat? What is, I said, specific? Specific heat means the amount of heat required. I said that it is an amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 gram or 1 kg or 1 mole of a substance through 1 degree Celsius. That is from the 14.5 to 15.5. Means I have to increase the temperature through only 1 degree Celsius. I said that, and then I said, suppose we have an in this container there is a water and 1 kg water, and I am giving the heat, and here we have a land mass, and that is also 1 kg, and I am giving a heat, and another, I said that in another container, in another container we have, I said, sand, and it is also how much? 1 kg. And if I, and I am giving, I said that heat. So when I give, I have given the heat to, I said that 1 kg of water around, I said that 400 calorie, around 400 calories. Suppose I have given how much? 400 calorie, its temperature has been increased by 1 degree Celsius. That is, I said that better to say 14.5 to 1 degree Celsius increased and reached to 15.5. Understood? How much heat I have given? 400 calorie. But in case of land mass, I supplied only 100 calorie, and the temperature of the land mass has been increased by, I said that, 1 degree Celsius. That is, I said that 14.5 to 15.5. So, for in comparison to the water, land mass has to be supplied more heat, land mass has to supply less heat, to increase the same temperature. So who has less specific heat? Landmass. Landmass has less specific heat. And in case of sand, when I supplied the heat, only 25 calorie, the temperature has been increased by 1 degree Celsius, that is, I said that 14.5 to 15.5. So this temperature has been increased. So you are able to see that the temperature has been increased for these substances at a different heat. Who has more need, who needed more heat to increase the temperature? Water. So specific heat of water is very high, and then specific heat of land mass is 4 times low, and then specific heat of this is in a water and this is in a land mass, and the specific heat of sand is very low. It means, but on the earth's surface, if you see, when the sun rays are coming, and when the sun rays are coming, and we have an, I said that one water body, one we have an land mass, and one region we have, I said that sand. The sun rays is giving equal heat to all. It will not do biasness. So suppose I said that, it means the water, land, sand, everyone will get the same heat. Everyone will get the same heat. I said that, but what happened? And the same heat, suppose I have given 400 calorie, the water body temperature will be how much? Water body temperature will be how much? Yes, tell me. 14.52, it will increase by 15.5. What will be the temperature of water body? 14.5 to 15.5? Is it okay? So 1 degree temperature has been increased. So what is the temperature in the morning? Suppose in the daytime I am giving the heat. The daytime, what is happening? The temperature of the water has increased by 15.5. Now land. Land mass kitna increase hoga? Yes, tell me, what will be the temperature of land mass in the morning when the 400 calorie can? Huh? It will be, I said that, humne kya bola? I said that water 1 kg ko heat karne mein hume 1 degree Celsius temperature to increase, we need 400 calorie. How much I need? 400 calorie. Land mass ko humne same 1 kg land mass ko I have given the heat, but at a temperature, only by giving 100 calorie heat, I got the increase of temperature by 1 degree Celsius. Yes? So specific heat kitna hai? Kitna hai? 100 calorie only. So what is the definition of specific heat? The amount of heat required to, what is I said that, raise the temperature of 1 kg of substance through. So land mass ko humne kitna heat diya? Only 100 calorie. Lekin water body ko humne kitna diya? 400 calorie. So isme 1 degree Celsius increase kiya aur isme 1 degree Celsius. So isme yadi, main yahan pe yadi 400 calorie heat isko de dunga, to there will be increase by 4 times. Yes or not? Water body ka temperature kitna hai? Dhyan se samjhe and be on time. Choti si cheez miss ho gayi to gaye kaam se. Water ko kitna heat diya apne? And what is the weight of the water? 1 kg. And how much temperature increase? 1 degree Celsius. That is 14.5 to 15.5. How much weight of land mass? How much weight of land mass? 1 kg. Aur usko apne kitna heat diya? When you have given only 100 calorie heat, its temperature is increased by 1 degree Celsius. 14.5 to 15.5. And again, sand bhi 1 kg hai. And you have given, what is it? 100 calorie bhi nahi diya. We have given only 25 calorie. The heat has been increased, temperature has been increased by 1 degree Celsius, 14.5. Toh yadi main, if I'll give the land, what is it? सभी को मैं 400 दे रहा हूं, 400 कैलोरी हीट, सन क्या देगा? सभी को सेम अमाउंट ऑफ हीट, और जब सभी को देगा तो इसकी टेम्परेचर 400 कैलोरी सपोज दे रहा है, सो व्हाट विल हैपन? इट्स टेम्परेचर विल बी इंक्रीज टू रीच 15.5. अब मैं वाटर को दूंगा 400, लैंड को 400 कैलोरी, 100 कैलोरी पे 1 डिग्री, तो 400 कैलोरी पे कितनी टेम्परेचर इंक्रीज करेगा? 4 डिग्री सेल्सियस मोर. तो 14.5 से 4 डिग्री सेल्सियस मोर, क्योंकि इसकी स्पेसिफिसिटी क्या है? लो है. तो कितनी हो जाएगी? 18.5. सो इट्स टेम्परेचर बिकम व्हाट? यस 18.5 और सैंड कितना हो जाएगा 16 टाइम्स, क्योंकि सैंड का टेम्परेचर 1 केजी को 1 डिग्री सेल्सियस इंक्रीज करने में कितना लग रहा है 25 कैलोरी, इट मींस इट नीड्स 16 टाइम्स इट विल इंक्रीज एंड 14.5 से सैंड का टेम्परेचर क्या होगा. सो समझ में आ रहा है व्हाई डू द डेजर्ट्स आर वेरी हॉट. Why do the deserts are very hot? Because the desert means sand has very low specific heat. The substrates having low specific heat, they will warm fast, get heated fast. Yes or not? क्योंकि सभी की absorption capacity अलग होती है. इसीलिए feel so if you go outside, तो आप लोग क्या देखोगे? कर उसी को करें करो उसको मुझे निचोड़ दिया. मैं बोल रहा हूं मुझे गर्मी लग रही है. व्हाट इज हैपनिंग. आई सेड इसका मतलब कि आई सेड दैट वाटर स्पेसिफिकेट इज हायर क्योंकि ये 400 कैलोरी पे इट्स टेम्परेचर इज इंक्रीजिंग बाय 1 डिग्री सेल्सियस. आई सप्लाइड 400 कैलोरी बट लैंड मास आई सप्लाइड ओनली 100 कैलोरी. इस टेम्परेचर इज इंक्रीज बाय 1 डिग्री सेल्सियस. लेकिन यदि मैं लैंड मास को 400 कैलोरी सप्लाई करूंगा तो इट विल इंक्रीज 4 टाइम्स मोर एंड इट विल बिकम 14.5 टू 18.5. एंड इफ द सेम एंड बट आई एम सप्लाइंग सैंड हाउ मच हीट 25 calorie and its temperature is in by 1 degree Celsius. But if I'll supply it, 400 calorie, it will be 16 more, times more. So it becomes what? 30.5. So earth pe sabse jyada garam region kaun sa hai? Which region is the most hot? Desert region. After that, which region? Land mass. And thereafter, water body. Samajh mein aa gaya? Due to what? Specific heat. What is the definition of specific? The amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 gram or 1 kg. हम लोग ने यहां 1 kg लिया हुआ है. 1 kg of substance through 1 degree Celsius. So if I come over here और इसी से आज हम लोग समझेंगे one factor of cyclone again. I said that this is I said Goa, yes, western coast, and this is in a water body, and in the daytime what will happen? First I said that in the daytime sun is giving same amount of heat to the nearby Arabian Sea or land mass, same heat but different heat. They will give same heat. Aisa to nahi hai sun wahan kam dega yahan zyada dega. So same heat on the water body, same heat in the Arabian Sea and same heat in the what? Goa. So in the daytime, who will get heated fast? Land will get heated fast or water body will get heated fast? Yeah? Land. Kyun? Specific heat of land is low. 4 times low. And it will get heated fast? Yes or no?